barakatuh. Ladies and gentlemen, standing here, I would like to tell my story under the title The Legend of Gunung Kelut.
Once upon a time, there was Majapahit Kingdom. Brawijaya was the king of Majapahit Kingdom. And he had a daughter named Princess Dia Ayu Puspayu. She was a very beautiful princess that made many young men love her very much. But she always refused their marriage proposals, and it made the king so sad. One day, the king called the princess.
Princess, come here, my daughter. Princess, you are the only my daughter, and you will govern this kingdom, also this culture. If it's not you, who will be? I'm getting older, so I want you to get married soon.
But father, I'm sorry. I just hope I can marry every man.
The answer of the princess made the king was mad. Then, the king said to the princess,
I know that you are looking for a good husband. So, I have an idea. I am going to hold a competition for you. If there is man can stretch Kiai Garuda Yaksaspo and lift Kiai Skadali Masko, he will be your husband. What do you think about?
And willingly, the princess agreed about the king's idea. And it made the king so happy. Later, in the competition, many young men joined that competition. Of course, because they all wanted to get married with the princess. One by one, every man tried to stretch the bow and lifted the goal. But no one succeeded. They all were injured. Their hands and backs were broken. That made the king plan to stop the competition. But before he stopped, suddenly a man came to him and shouted,
I am Lebu Suro, want to try this competition?
Everybody was looking at him. He was really strange. His head was unlike his head, but he had a bull's head.
Lebu Suro, I'm sure you can win this competition. Of course, Your Majesty. I'm sure that I can win this competition.
Then Lembu Suro tried to stretch the bow, and yes! Lembu Suro succeeded! And also when he lifted the goal, it also meant that Lembu Suro would marry with the princess. Everybody applauded. They were amazed by his power. But it's not for the princess. The princess was very sad. She never thought that she would marry with a man who had a bull's head. And the king had no choice. He had to keep his promise as the king. Later, the king asked to his servants to prepare a wedding ceremony. A ceremony was getting closer and closer. That meant the princess was very, very sad. She didn't want to get married with Lembu Suro. She was thinking of her guests at the wedding. Then, the princess asked to the king. Father, please ask the Muslim to make welcome to the bed on the bed of the room. The king was released for the first time. So later, he asked Lembu Suro to go to on top of Gunung Kelut. When he arrived, Lembu Suro started to dig the ground. He was digging and digging until the hole was deep. But suddenly, some soldiers pushed him into the hole. stay back to your life. The booster was helpless. He could not do anything until he dead. And before he dead, the booster aggressed the king.
King Brahmijaya, wait for my defense! I will destroy your kingdom!
Everybody was so scared. They believed that the booster would defend to the kingdom. And until now, every time when Gunodur appears, people say that Gunodur is doing his revenge. So ladies and gentlemen, I think enough, that's all of my story. Thank you very much for your attention. And the last I say, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.